So, Charlie, what is going on in Fairhaven? What do people need to know?
Sure. I'm very happy with how Fairhaven has responded to the COVID-19 emergency. Just to give you some background here, our first responders, firefighters, EMTs, and police officers have done a remarkable job keeping our residents safe and responding to emergency calls. And so far, since they've been following strict safety protocols and have adequate supply of PPEs, we've been very fortunate that none of our frontline workers have been exposed to the virus.
Excellent.
It's also fortunate that we added staff to the fire and police department over the past few years so that we have sufficient people on the ground to respond to the pandemic. Our Board of Health,
good.
Mary, has been doing amazing. And supported by the Fairhaven Community Television and IT department, they've provided great educational material regarding COVID-19. It's been sent to people's homes about COVID-19 prevention and containment. And as I go about town, I'm very proud to see our residents are following the guidelines, including proper social distancing and wearing face masks whenever that's not possible. And although our municipal offices are currently closed to the public, we have not been closed for business. Most, if not all, of our municipalities' services continue to be provided, albeit in a different fashion, mostly online, by telephone or by appointment. This would not be possible without the hard work and dedication of our town employees.
Yeah, it's got to be tough being locked up in those buildings when you're used to the hustle and bustle of people coming and going, and now it's just down to a limited amount of people, and got to make for long days.
It does, and they're still very dedicated, and a lot of people are working from home, but they're answering the phones, they're responding to people's needs, and, still getting permits, still doing, the essentials that we need to do, but we expect to open the municipal offices to the public when the governor implements phase two of the reopening plan. So,
excellent.
How are we prepared for that? Well, we prepared that we have taken steps to ensure safety of our town employees and also the public. We've installed plexiglass shields at counters, making sure there will be hand sanitizers available, and implementing social distancing protocols, among other things.
We're speaking with Charlie Murphy, who's the chairman of the Board of Selectmen here in Fairhaven. Charlie, regarding restaurants and things like that, has anything changed, or that's all coming down the road, right?
That's coming down the road, yes. I mean, you still can get curbside pickup. You still can get to go. And, phase two will bring about more. And restaurants were getting the protocol in place now to do phase two and phase three. So the businesses in our community are really preparing hard because, they want to reopen, fully. So they're taking all the safety protocols. Certain businesses have submitted reports to the Board of Health, so they can get up and running and get your hair cut starting, next week.
Right.
I know that, a lot of the salons are looking forward to phase two, so that they can, do more, for our community, and restaurants are also looking forward to that, and the businesses, they've really responded well to this pandemic. They really have.
And Charlie, for the people who don't know, I don't know why they wouldn't, but you also, have a life outside of being selectman with the Mo Life program. How are things with your organization?
I'll be honest with you, Chris, my staff are incredible. Once again, they've responded to this. Our consumers were stuck at home, couldn't go out. So my staff created Zoom meetings, a cooking show, a history show, and participants all love it. They Zoom in and they still make that connection. And now with, phase one starting, my staff are going to people's houses and socially distancing outside and, checking in with people, sharing ideas about what they want to do for work, or, in the community. So they've just responded really well, and we're getting people, to have some social, whether it be by computer or phone or visual. So I can't speak high enough for my staff. They're just incredible.
We're speaking with Charlie Murphy, who's the chairman of the Board of Selectmen here in Fairhaven. So Charlie, if people want more information about what's going on in Fairhaven regarding all of this, where's the best place for them to get information?
Go right to Fairhavenmass.org. go right to that, and that'll give you every up-to-date status that you need to find. And if you need a shellfish permit, there are some shellfish applications outside of Town Hall, or you can go online and get a shellfish permit. I mean, so life is continuing. Life mm-hmm. is continuing. It's just a little different, and as phase two comes, it'll be gradually reintroducing things more and more, and then phase three, and then we'll all celebrate when we get to phase four.
Anything people should know about the town beaches for this weekend?
Well, the town beaches, I believe, are following the protocol of the governor, and which is that you need to stay socially distanced. The parking lots probably won't be open yet, but you know, just everyone just to really follow the protocols and we'll be safe.
Beautiful, beautiful. Well, Charlie, listen, I appreciate you taking some time, spending with us, updating us what's going on here in Fairhaven. Good luck, be safe. I appreciate everything you're doing.
Okay, thank you. You too. Thank you very much. And once again, a huge shout out to our community who are just really pulling it together to get through this all together.
Excellent. Thanks a lot for the call. I appreciate it. That was Charlie Murphy, chairman of the Board of Selectmen here in Fairhaven.